10 prepares to air a new documentary on the case. Lindy Chamberlain told The Project that all these years later, she's still howled at by strangers.
Is it going to be judged regardless of what you do? So you may as well be true to yourself and just take your own path.
Kerri-Anne, it's pretty awful that all these years later she's still being hounded by people making these sickening jokes about her missing baby. It really did become a trial by media in a way,
without question,
didn't it?
Well, I was working here at Channel 10 with Good Morning Australia during that time, literally 40 years ago today, as, you know, the trial went on. It was just shocking. Constantly we listened to our reporters up there who thought she was innocent. But here is a woman who was actually convicted just because she did not look like and sound like a grieving mother. Mm. Originally, that's exactly what it was down to. There were lots of other terrible remarks about their religion, Seventh-day Adventists, that Azaria was wearing black and it was sacrificial. All this nonsense came up and Australia and many Australians bought into it, and to this very day will still have an opinion about it. But simply because she was quiet, she was dignified in her silence, she didn't grieve like other people thought she would grieve, I didn't actually have any question right from the word go that a dingo took little Azaria, almost a newborn baby, beautiful smell. They will do that. They are predators. Mm. So this woman was jailed because she didn't fit our norm. And the Northern Territory, the Justice Department or Injustice Department, bought into that and wanted her found guilty, and they did. It was a disgraceful period of our time, and this woman and her family, her entire life has been coloured by the events of that single day. Her marriage disintegrated. The kids.
She was pregnant,
her other children,
and she went to jail.
Yeah, and yeah. She was pregnant when she went to jail. And it was just a terrible time in our history that just doesn't seem to have gone away, and people to actually be logical about this. It was just terrible.
It was...
And nonsense about the Tirana and the blood spatters. The forensic was rubbish. There was no
it was
blood splatter.
It was absolutely awful. Yeah, they couldn't even tell fluids apart. It was some sort of motor fluid in the car or behind the dashboard, I think.
Remember they alleged that Michael was carrying the baby's body around in the camera bag.
It's sickening.
While the search was on. It was ridiculous.
And, of course, she said that the baby was wearing a matinee jacket and they never found it, and so they thought she's lying about that, so she's lying about everything else.
And then it turned up.
And then, that's right, so the very year that we went to the Northern Territory and travelled through the Northern Territory was right at the time where they had just found the matinee jacket. And it's probably worth remembering that it was only because someone fell to their death, an English tourist fell to their death off Uluru. And it was during the search for his body, which took 8 days.
Wow.
That's how big this place... I mean, Uluru is a huge, vast, amazing place, incredibly vast. It took 8 days for them to find his body, an adult man, which is tragic enough. Imagine how long it would take to find the jacket of a tiny little baby. Anyway, they found the jacket. Everything this near a dingo lair, torn, blood on it. Everything that Lindy Chamberlain had said suddenly was true, and she was, I think, released that year. And this was all while we were in the Northern Territory, travelling right up the guts of it, right up the centre of it, from Alice to Uluru to Darwin, and it was just electrifying. Like, you just could not imagine a bigger story. Absolutely everyone was talking about it. Absolutely everyone was either convinced she was innocent, convinced she was guilty, and it was such a surreal time.
Imagine being in the thick of that, though. Imagine being Lindy, having lost your baby in the most horrific of circumstances, and then being accused by half the country of killing your own baby. Mm.
And you know what? And who knows? People react differently, but you would shut down. I would almost cease to. Like, if I'd lost my child, I would not know how to cope. Either I'd completely lose my mind and maybe even end it all, or I would just completely just
and then
cease to exist.
You look at what's happened in the intervening 40 years. Her story has become a movie. Meryl Streep played her, got nominated for an Oscar. There's an opera. Opera Australia did. The phrase has gone into the stratosphere. You know, it turns up everywhere, and she's had to absorb all of that too. I mean, I'd love to know what she thinks of the film, what she thinks of the opera, what she thinks of Elaine from Seinfeld joking about.
That's right. It is surreal because these things, and I'm not going to be terribly judgy of those things because.
I'd love to know what she thinks.
Once things entered the popular culture, like she became like a fixture in Australian Women's Weekly, like a. You know, like a, you know, like a first lady of Australia, almost like a Hazel Hawke or something like that, where she was this sort of Australian icon, this sort of iconic celebrity as a result of this unthinkable tragedy. And I know just from being a journalist for ages, you see people who become famous as a result of great horror being inflicted upon them, and it is a really... It changes who you are on the inside. It turns your soul.
Yeah. Well, the new documentary giving rare insight into this incredible case is called A Dingo's Got My Baby, the Lindy Chamberlain story, and it is coming soon to 10 and Win.